worked. Hopkins wasn't asking the kinds of questions that we, as modern writers and critics, might ask. What does it mean? What's this about? He was much more interested in exactly the nuts and bolts of each line, of how accent, stress, and rhythm could be seen to work.
Prior to the advent of modernist free verse, there are two different kinds of rhythm. There's the kind that was current until the Renaissance, in which all that matters is how many beats there are in a line, how many stressed syllables there are in a line. At the time of the Renaissance, we replaced that with a slightly more complicated form of meter, accentual syllabic rhythm, in which the number of unstressed syllables in the line matter as well as the number of stressed syllables. The interesting thing was that the old system, accentual scansion, survived in popular verse, like nursery rhymes. Ding dong bell, pussy's in the well, which three beats a line, but no, in some lines there are no unstressed syllables at all, ding dong bell. In others, pussy's in the well, there are some unstressed syllables. Hopkins, who says perfectly openly, yes, of course, you can find it in nursery rhymes. What he does, really, is just take it and say, I'm going to write serious adult poetry in what other people would call accentual scansion, but which he calls sprung rhythm.
Usually poetry is based on a fairly regular alternation of stressed with unstressed syllables. What Hopkins did with his sprung rhythm was really to break that regularity up in a very radical way and to cram in more stressed syllables juxtaposed than is usual in English verse. This is from Pied Beauty. All things counter, original, spare, strange, whatever is fickle, freckled, who knows how, with swift, slow, sweet, sour, adazzle, dim, he fathers forth whose beauty is past change, praise him. And you can hear then, and I was trying to emphasise, the stressed rhythms of that poem, praise him at the end, a hymn of praise to God. It gives the poetry an enormous vitality, buoyancy, vigour. It's a muscular poetry.